Hi, I'm Shannon Gavin Johnson, the Director of Legacy Museum on Main, and this is a brief moment in LaGrange's history. When LaGrange was first organized in 1828, only three denominations organized churches here: the Methodists, Baptists, and the Presbyterians. For many years, the only churches founded in Troup County belonged to these denominations. However, when the Civil War broke out in 1861, refugees from New Orleans and Mobile fled to LaGrange away from the battlefront. These refugees sought denominations similar to the ones in their homes, and on October 14, 1863, the Right Reverend Stephen Elliott, Bishop of the Diocese of Georgia, confirmed a class of six and baptized two babies. The congregation was officially organized on March 28, 1864 as St. Mark's Parish with 31 members under the leadership of the Reverend Charles W. Thomas. As they were without a church building, the congregation met in the sanctuaries of the Presbyterian and the Methodist churches, as well as occasionally using Sterling Hall on the square where Flagpole Park is today. Following a sermon by Episcopal Bishop Cleland Nelson at a service held in First Methodist Church, members began looking to build a church of their own. A lot on the southeast corner of Battle and Church Streets was purchased in 1892, and the first building was constructed the following year. In 1906, the Reverend Harry D. Phillips arrived to serve the church through a program of missions and outreach. Two Episcopal churches were established to serve local mill workers, Good Shepherd and Holy Comforter churches, as well as St. Elizabeth's Mission established on Revis Street to serve the African American community. St. Elizabeth's Mission is noted for its mission school, which opened for kindergartners in 1920 and would eventually educate about 10% of the local African American children. In 1945, the church's original home on Church Street was sold to the congregation Bethel and converted to a Jewish synagogue. The Episcopal congregation worshipped at Good Shepherd Church until a new church was built. Dr. Emory Park donated a lot on North Greenwood to the congregation in 1946, and Arthur B. Edge Jr. donated an adjoining lot. Daniel Lumber Company began construction on the English Gothic-style building in 1948. The new church was dedicated Christmas Eve of 1949. The following year, Good Shepherd Church was closed and merged with St. Mark's. Funds from the sale of the church were used to construct a fellowship hall in the basement. A $100,000 bequest from Alfred Dunson in 1951 allowed the church to purchase adjacent property. In 1952, the church was officially deemed a full parish and the rectory next door was purchased. This was a busy year for the church, as they also established a mission church, St. John's, in West Point. Using the remaining money from Dunson's bequest, the church undertook a plan to remodel the building and add a large parish hall next door to the sanctuary in 1961. The money also paid for the monumental carved stone Celtic cross that still stands in front of the sanctuary. One side displays the shields of the 12 apostles, and the other side shows worldly emblems reminding parishioners leaving the building to ask themselves, "Who are you, where are you going, and why?" In 1966, the parish's mission to the African American community, St. Elizabeth's, closed their doors and merged with the St. Mark's congregation. Around the same time, the church established St. Mark's Kindergarten, which provided a preschool education for many children in the community until 2020, when it too closed its doors. To learn more about the religious history of LaGrange, visit Legacy Museum on Main. This has been a brief moment in LaGrange's history.